Hello, hello World Rally fans all over the world. I'm back again with another video. I hope you enjoyed the Rally of Monte Carlo this weekend. And yeah, the last video I posted was Super Stage 3. Special Stage 3, Special Stage 4 and Special Stage 5. So after Special Stage 5, you have Sebastian Ogier leading by 11.3 seconds. So that's after the Friday morning. The three stages was won by Ogier. On Friday it was Tanak that took the first two stages, and he had a couple seconds up on Evans. But on Saturday morning, Ogier's brake problem that he had the day before, he managed to conquer it and drive really well. He won Special Stage 3, Special Stage 4 and Special Stage 5. So Ogier had 11.3 seconds lead on Evans. But in the second leg of the Friday, in the second leg of the Friday, stage 6 and stage 7, yeah, Special Stage 6 and Stage 7, Ogier, during stage 6, while he was driving, he must have collected a puncture, and he lost the wheel. And obviously, in World Rally driving, when you're driving and you pick up a puncture, because the road is so unbalanced and unsurfaced, it can actually rip the tires off your car, and you just down to the rim. So Ogier was down to the rim. He managed to get to the end of stage 6, yeah. He lost about 30 seconds. So his 11.3 second lead, his 11.3 second lead was wiped out. So now Ogier is angry now. So in especially stage 7 now, Ogier comes back and he gained about 16 seconds, you know. So he was about 23 seconds down going into stage 7 on Friday evening. Ogier was 23 seconds down on Evans. So Evans is thinking, look, if I just drive carefully and keep up with the times, I'll be able to put an impact on Ogier or maybe win this rally. But Ogier said, nah, Special Stage 7, Ogier came, he gained about 16 seconds and he cut down the lead of Evans to 7.4 seconds. And he said he was very angry, so he must have been pushing, and he, you know, in driving you can push to the limits here, but you can't really push too far over the limit, if you know what I mean. If you push too far over the limit, you can either lose the car, go off. So you can push here, but you gotta control the power and the brakes and stuff like that. So Ogier can do that, he can push here without over pushing, if you know what I mean. So he pushed. He said he was very angry, so he said, look, I'm here to win this rally. I'm not gonna not win this rally. That's what I'm gonna do. So he had that determination after Special Stage 6, where he lost 30 seconds. He knew the car was good. He knows his skills. He knows himself as a 7-time world champion. So he went for it, and then he clawed back. So he just got to 7.4 seconds. So Friday night, him probably going to bed, he probably had a better feeling about himself for the Saturday morning. So moving on, you had Tanak 17.5 seconds adrift of Evans after special stage 7. This is because Tanak said, yeah, when he's coming towards the hairpins, braking and turning, he's losing power to pick up the power to move from the hairpins. Tanak said he was struggling with that, and it could be like the Hyundai's engine giving too much power and the braking not balancing out. So when he's got so much power and he's braking, it's not balancing out. So when he brakes and he's trying to pick up the power back, the fuel influx into the engine is not picking up. So you go thin it out, you go kind of fine it out and make a couple of settings. So it's got something to do with throttle application, power boost in it out of the hairpins. You know, and it could be breaking into the hairpins as well. You have to analyze those situations. So Tanak struggled after Friday, where he was leading the first two stages, special stages. He struggled on a Saturday in the evening. And then Robin Perra in the other Toyota, he made it, what's it called, he made it into fourth place. He was about 52 seconds behind Evans, you know. And then Thierry Neuville, who's got a new co-driver, Thierry Neuville, who drives the Hyundai, the same car as Oit Tanak and Dani Sordo, he was in fifth, and he's got a new co-driver. So he was a winner of last year's Rally Monte Carlo. So he's finding his feet. He's really finding his feet in the new co-driver. He's really finding his feet with a new co-driver. So that's a good one. That's a good one. And then Dani Sordo was in sixth place. He said he had no confidence because he had to. Because of the tire choices that he made, they had to pick three winter tires and one studded. So he had no confidence in the car, Dani Sordo, in the Hyundai i20. So that meant that he couldn't really push, you know, and that's that was a problem for him. And also, while OJ was driving on Special Stage 7, he had three winter tires and one studded tire. So that's the tire balance that he chose. And he said about 2 kilometers into the stage, the tire started to fall off at the rear a little bit, but he still made it back, you know. So they said they're gonna talk to Pirelli to find out how they can improve the tires and stuff like that, you know. So yeah, yeah, that was a good stage, and OJ's recovery was really, really great. And I'm hoping that he can. I'm hoping that it can be more excitement in World Rally Championship to come. So the next video is gonna be stage 9 and 10. I don't think there was a stage 8, especially stage 8. There was stage 9 and 10. So we're looking forward to that. Respect.